Hey guys, this is David Kwan. So this video is just a regular channel update. I'm just telling you about how my life was going on this day of March 16th just now. So never mind, March 16th, 2013, that's pretty much when I'm recording this. Although it's going to be more about March 15th. But yeah, so today, you know, my life is kind of, it's pretty much the same old thing. Still jobless after having quit my canvassing job. Been applying to a bunch of different places, but I don't know. Like it's been an interesting thing because I feel like it's such a high point in my life. I know it's such a weird thing to say as an unemployed lazy bum, but it actually does feel that way. Right now, I've started volunteering at Housing Works of all places. That's wow. Life takes a full circle because that's the place I started as an intern in college. That's like one of my very first social work. Yeah, it's like one of my very, no, it's my second, but it pretty much counts as my first. But yeah, it's like that's where I started this whole thing in Housing Works. I was a social work intern in Housing Works, the case management program, which is Manhattan Community Follow-Up Program. So I assisted different case management teams there. But now I'm back to volunteering at Housing Work thrift store. Not the thrift store, but it's like the special events division there. That kind of just organizes fundraising events and special events that benefit Housing Works as a whole. And Housing Works is an organization that's the largest organization in the country that provides for the needs and serves people living with HIV and AIDS and needs housing services and assistance. So that's Housing Works in a nutshell, and I'm starting to volunteer there again. One of the most interesting things I've heard today was, at the end of the day, after I finished volunteering, I talked with the volunteer coordinator to talk about my schedule and stuff, like, you know, how often I'll be volunteering and what days, and it was interesting because I was just like, yeah, I'm currently doing nothing, this is it. I mean, I'm going to have more volunteer activities, but right now, this is like, I'm unemployed, not doing anything, this is rough, so I'm just here. And the other volunteer coordinator was like, so, like, what are you doing in your free time? I'm just like, oh, you know, I mean, job searching, writing short stories, playing video games, volunteering like this, you know. And he's just like, living the life. And, you know, I mean, it's not too far from the truth. I feel like this is, like, the one moment in my life where I'm just like, I'm just doing whatever the hell I want to do. I'm not really tied down to anything currently, at least for this month and probably for majority of next month. Money's not an issue. I can pay my rent fine. I can pay my student loan payments fine. I have money in my account. It's not a lot, but it's enough to last me till the end of next month. So it's like, this is like the time in my life where just like I'm content. I'm doing whatever I want, and I'm finding out that whatever I want to do is kind of just, other than being a lazy bum who plays video games and makes blogs and writes short stories, other than that, I'm actually still going out there trying my best, like waking up and going to volunteer and doing stuff that, you know, I think is pretty good for, you know, the work environment. It's a totally different contrast to what happened after I was fired from working at the shelter. Because after I was fired from there, I was pretty much just a lazy bum, just moping around at home, doing nothing, you know, playing a lot of video games and watching a lot of Netflix, and hanging out with a few friends, you know, like each week, but pretty much just being like a waste of air on the planet, pretty much, like, that's how I view it. But currently, like, money's been taken out of the equation. I'm not doing anything for money currently, and I am doing my best, and it's been like a thing, you know, where there was a tweet directed at me when I was kind of having a back and forth conversation on Twitter with someone, and that person kind of, it was a topic we were talking about, kind of just, what were we talking about? I don't know. But one thing that kind of struck out to me is she said that, like, oh, you sound like you're trying to prove yourself to someone. And I kind of gave a non-answer then. I was just like, eh, I mean, I wouldn't necessarily, no, I kind of switched the topic, so I gave a non-answer. But honestly, I do think, yeah, I mean, in a way, I am trying to prove something. And in this case, I think I'm wanting to prove to myself that my heart is in the right direction. You know, I quit canvassing because I found out that I stopped enjoying doing the work, which was a shock to me. And it's just been, I still have an inner turmoil of like, who I am, what I'm gonna do, all this kind of internal like thingy of figuring out what to do, you know. And so in that sense, like now I've, in some moments recently, I've started trying to question even just the career path I'm on and stuff. And if that's questioned, like, what the hell do I do afterwards, you know? But it's been good trying to, you know, just doing, just volunteering in different organizations, because really, ideally, nonprofit job is like, it's the most, like, what would you call it? Like, oxymoronic thing kind of ever. Because nonprofit, like, is the word is nonprofit. You're supposed to be just working for the benefit of society and for other people. But reality of the matter is, you can't do this work without money. And without, like, you know, paying the workers' income. So it has to be a job, unfortunately. It's not like some, like, there's all these rich people around the world who want to, you know, spend their own money and spend their own time to help people in need. Sorry, that's not reality. So unfortunately, nonprofit, it's a job. And so there's a lot of money involved in nonprofit work, unfortunately. And this is one of the key things that struck me the most when I was working in a homeless shelter. We had this training. And in that training, the lecturer or the trainer, whatever you consider that the title of that person is, just made a random comment. I don't know why that this comment came up. It was just like, yeah, you know, oh, I think it was because she wanted us to relate to the people who are homeless. But she said, if homelessness was solved tomorrow, and every homeless people just got a job and got out of their situation, well, guess what? We would be out of jobs and we would become homeless, because now, you know, so that was kind of a joke comment, but at the same time, it's kind of true. I mean, it's also same thing about like different kinds of service organizations. My mom's a nurse, and currently she's working in a hospital where the problem is they're not getting enough patients. And so they've had to cut down some hours of the nurses, and there's a slight chance like some nurses are going to become part-time. You know, hospitals are great. They help people, but at the same time, hospitals can't function without sick people. You know, that kind of thing. So that made me kind of really cynical about this whole career path for some reason. And so, like, ideally, I would love to do, like, a for-profit work as a way to make money, and then just kind of, you know, use my own time and money for nonprofit work. That would be ideal. Unfortunately, I'm not rich or anything like that, and I haven't found anything that I would be passionate about in for-profit world. So this whole month for me, I think, is just trying to figure out a lot about myself, a lot about what I'm doing with my life. And it's like I said, in that manner, even though I'm currently jobless, even though I don't know when I'll get a job again, I have some job interviews lined up. I'm not too optimistic about any of those things. But, you know, even though I'm in that situation, it feels like this is like one of the highest points in my life, just because I'm finally starting to, like, you know, actually experience just what I've always wanted to experience. Doing nonprofit work, not for pay, because that's what I do. I like just doing nonprofit work, just to do nonprofit work, because it's supposed to be nonprofit. There isn't supposed to be like any money involved in nonprofit. That's the ideal. In reality, that just can't be the case. It's kind of impossible for that to be the case unless we have a bunch of rich people just dedicating their own money and their own time for nonprofit causes. Until that happens, not going to be the case where nonprofit, the whole term, actually means nonprofit. Just not going to happen. But yeah, so that's been it. I recently wrote a blog on my blog post, just kind of thinking about in this line of thought, like, I feel like the richest man ever, because I don't have to worry about money and I'm just doing whatever. And, you know, they're just saying the rich don't quit working just because they're rich. They really don't. The rich continue to work hard as before to become even richer, and they usually do become even richer and richer and richer, and they keep working their ass off, even when it's past their retirement time. I think it's in their drive to keep working and working. And although, you know, the reason the rich work so hard is to become richer, I feel like, well, you know, I would be content if this is like the highest point in my life. If I became a millionaire right now, I want to believe, this is not true, but I want to believe that nothing much is going to change, that I will continue to live my life just like this, you know, just kind of idling my free time away, and then just kind of volunteering in nonprofit organizations when I have the drive and the time, and when I really enjoy doing so. So currently, I'm at like the most spoiled, the most, I don't know, just content place I'm in. I think I know in the future I look towards is gonna be, it's gonna be pretty tough. It's gonna be pretty hectic, pretty busy. I just know that. I just learned yesterday that I got accepted into graduate school for social work for the two-year program. I didn't get accepted into the one-year program because my academic record was not strong enough. But yeah, I guess I'm gonna pursue my master's now. It's gonna start in August, so that's gonna happen. So yeah, it's gonna be a crazy, just busy future. So I know that in the future, when I look back at my March 2013, it's gonna be like, yeah, that was like a really good relaxing time for me. So I think I'll look back at March 2013 pretty fondly. Like, this was a time in my life where I felt like a millionaire, just because I don't really care about money right now. I'm just kind of doing whatever I want to do, and that's like, it's like the best moment in my life currently. So like the volunteer coordinator said, I'm living the life, apparently.